We're on the top of the ramparts here, the old bastions, and you can see houses have been built all across here over the centuries. We're now going to go back down inside the wall, into the inner city. And if you look here, here's a nice little detail. Maybe get a focus of that hocker. Look at that. It's inverted, but that's the double eagle. The double eagle that symbolizes the Habsburgs' dual monarchy, Austrian-Hungary. These are imperial bricks, ordered by the emperor, especially for his bastions. Like Paris and Rome, Vienna is a city of two parts. There's the city above ground, that we can see now, and then there's the city that's hidden below ground. Of course, to discover subterranean Vienna, you have to know where to look. And I happen to know that this shop is one of those special places. This is the Tossmann's shop. The place to come for your lederhosen, your pretty dirndls for ladies, and piles of alpine woolly socks. Perfect for an exploration. But we're also here to explore these wonderful medieval cellars. This building was built by the abbots and the monks of Melk Abbey up on the Danube. In 1629, they got a license from the city of Vienna to live here in this huge and beautiful house. It's now the shop. They also got a deal whereby they could sell wine from their vineyards in Vienna, all 40,000 litres of it every year. And they needed a place to store it, and they stored it in these cellars. They're three stories deep, all made of brick. Beautifully cool. That's what you need for storing wine. Now the cellars are used by the shop for exhibiting their collection of traditional Austrian ware. But the deeper we go, the stronger is the sense of the history of this place. There's a wonderful story dating back to 1944 and the years of the Second World War. People used to come down here to shelter from the Allied air raids. You can see why. They're very, very strongly built. There's a story that one night, a woman came down here and got lost. She didn't reappear for about 3 days. Miles and miles away across the city. How had she got there? This story is a great reminder. Until recently, subterranean Vienna was a completely independent and connected world. All these cellars were linked by sewers and tunnels, a mirror world of the world above on the street. That lady did reappear eventually, although it said her hair had turned quite white. She'd gone stark raving mad.